against Israel. So pretty much he was echoing the prophecy that we read in here. See? Verse 15, and many among them shall stumble and fall and be broken and be snared and be taken. Verse 16, bind up the testimony, bind up the testimony, seal the law among my disciples. So we see here in biblical prophecy, in particular the prophecy concerning our Lord Yahushua, the word testimony is associated with it. The prophecy is actually expounding on the testimony of our Lord Yahushua, which complements what we read in the book of Revelation, the 19th chapter and the 10th verse. What a testimony of our Lord Yahushua is the spirit of prophecy. For one, this proves that that testimony is not some new idea only written in the book of Revelation. No, that same testimony is spoken of right here in biblical prophecy. See? Now, when you click on this word, testimony, you're going to see where the two pretty much complements one another. The testimony we read about in the book of Revelation, the 19th chapter, you're going to see where it actually goes hand in hand with this testimony that we read in here in prophecy, man. And it says, testimony, attestation, confirmation, testimony, look, prophetic, injunction, testimony, prophetic, injunction. So you see the connection. The testimony that we read in here concerning prophecy in the book of Isaiah, the 8th chapter, actually goes hand in hand with the testimony in Revelation, the 19th chapter, and the 10th verse, which is referred to as the spirit of prophecy. What we see here with this word testimony in Isaiah, the 8th chapter, is in the same breath with prophetic injunction.